G'day everyone, welcome to my studio. Today I'm going to do a resin painting on my Lazy Susan. So I've already got all my colours mixed. I've got Mount Marte oil paints. So I've got a blue, a yellow, and a Titanic white. And then in here I have some spray paint. It's very transparent, very, very transparent. I just squirted some in there and mixed it with resin. And I've got black gray pigment, mica pigment. I mixed myself to get a nice color. And I've got a beautiful, like a magenta type in there. So okay, let's get started. So I was thinking of doing, so I've cleaned this really well and wiped it with alcohol. So I'm just gonna, I wanted to do the edges in white, because I've got a black ottoman it sits on. So I wanted a bit of a contrast. Oh, and I probably did not level this really well. So we'll see how we go. Always use my hands. And I can actually spin it now, which is pretty cool. Not too worried about it going underneath. Like I said, this is just for me, and I should be able to fix the underneath after. I love working on glass and love working with oil paints with resin. Providing that they mix well. So I'm going to go forward a little bit, get it a little bit off the edge to try and prevent the spillage or leakage. Over here. Yeah, I was looking at this Lazy Susan for weeks now, thinking one of these days I'm going to make you look interesting. Okay, so that's that. Just a little torch, pop those bubbles. Okay, we're still on? Yes, we are. Alrighty. Oh, let's just see. Do not have a strict plan. But I sort of want something coming from the middle out. So I wonder if I should even just do a dirty pour and see how that goes. I might actually just try and do that. Just grab myself a little cup. And I'll just get a little bit of alcohol in these just to help me create some interesting interesting patterns. Why aren't you working? That's alright. Lucky I've got another little one somewhere. So each one should have a little bit even there. Okay, so let's go with the dirty pour. I'll actually leave this white in here. Let's go with the yellow, straight in. Always leave a little bit in the cup so you can. Can you see me doing this? Where's my hand? Oh, there I am. Okay, so then I will go in with blue, but I want to get it on the side a little bit. Oh wow, it's going a little bit crazy. A little bit of black. across this lovely magenta on the side, because I want to keep the color, I don't want it really mixing too much. And some of this. Alrighty. Hopefully I will have enough. Make a little spout. And start pouring. There's the middle. Wow. The green and the blue. Sorry, I got quiet because I'm concentrating. I just want to make sure everything is going good. Must mix, move that a bit. Got some really interesting things happening already. So just with the heat, I'm just moving it, spreading it out a bit. Help. Just gonna add a little bit of this blue in here. Just a little bit of interest. And this yellow. Just filling in these bits. And I'll let resin do its thing. I'll help it a bit with movement. But I just don't want to disturb it too much. But here. So just moving that in, helping them merge. Okay. Right. Okay, so when I see something like that, it's really upsetting because it's like a lumpy bit. So I need a little bit more white, which I will mix in here real quick, because I've got heaps of resin left. Start off a little bit first.
got to give it a really good mix. And get some alcohol in there because I want to get, like I said, some cool effects. Oh, this is quite interesting. I need to tilt it a bit over this way. It's definitely going underneath now. Too much. Which is cool. I'm going to get my hairdryer involved. So the hairdryer gives a different effect. Okay, let's go. Happy with that, except need some more. Need to fix up these. Somebody to scoop this up. And I've got some other work to do. That's pretty cool. So I'll stop that now. Dismiss.